thank God for this hour that He's given to us. We want to look into His Word to share something that He laid upon my heart. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. So the theme of my this thing as I received, it says that prayer is the womb of manifestation. The womb of manifestation is the place of prayer. Hallelujah. So prayer is a womb that brings great manifestations of the promises of God, of the many, many things that God intends to do. Hallelujah. We will take our scripture from Isaiah chapter 66, and I'll read from 8, Isaiah 66, 8 and 9. Hallelujah. It says, who had heard such a thing? Who had seen such things? Shall the earth be made to bring forth in one day? Or shall nations be born at once? For as soon as Zion travailed, she brought forth her children. Shall I bring to birth and not cause to bring forth? Saith the Lord. Shall I cause to bring forth and shut the womb? Saith God. Amen. This is a scripture that the Lord conveyed through His servant or the prophet Isaiah concerning His works and how He moves in the affairs of His own people. And He brought our minds to the understanding concerning putting to birth or bringing forth children. And when or bringing forth nations or whatever the scripture has said, we can see that something to be brought forth will be brought forth through a womb. And He was talking about how Zion will travail for these things to come to pass. Hallelujah. When we look at into the Bible from the beginning, God did extraordinary things instantly. When He was putting forth or bringing back the form of the earth to shape it and make it as it was, or what He designed in His mind or His counsel, He just spoke it forth. Let there be light, and light came. Let there be fruit, the trees, the animals, everything, and they came. But afterwards, God gave man the seed. So, continuing with what God has done also took some time. It was not instant from that time. Hallelujah. God gave man seed. And when a seed is sown, it is sown in the womb of the earth. And it takes some period that the seed that has been put forth will spring up and then bring its fruit. But from the time that Adam sold his estate to the devil through disobedience and sin, from that time everything changed. And when the second Adam came, he just laid down a path for us to follow. Before his coming, we understand that promises was given to some people. One of them was Simon, who was waiting for the consolation of Israel. And the Bible says that he will not die till his eyes see the salvation of the Lord. So all along, he was very old. And in his old age, he did not sit down waiting to see, but he was in prayer. And during the time of prayer, God brought forth the promise. And when the promise was brought forth, the Spirit of God told Simon that the time has come for him to see what God has promised. That means that God's counsel will always stand. Anything that God has said will surely come to pass. Anna, the Bible said, was also in the temple interceding, praying for the restoration of Israel, for the salvation of the Lord. So, in the womb of prayer, the Savior was brought forth. Hallelujah. All along, these people were interceding and praying. And it happened when the child came forth. The Spirit of the Lord led Simon to the temple exactly the right time and the right thing, the right moment, he met the parents and then he uttered great things by the Spirit. And he told the Lord, "My eyes have seen thy salvation. Let thy servant depart in peace." Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. So his prayer brought to pass the promise of God. The Lord has made a lot of promises to us. And these promises are, the Bible says that his promises are yea and amen. But for these promises to manifest, something needs to be done. They need to be birthed through the womb of prayer. Hallelujah. And that is what the body of Christ have not understood. But those who have understood are enjoying the blessings of God through prayer. One of the things that believers sometimes do is that when there is the need, we engage in serious prayer through birthing. But when the promises of God come, we forget the place of prayer. We forget to secure what the Lord has brought with prayer. And when it happens like that, you see that the enemy attacks and takes back again. If we look at the lifestyle of Jesus Christ, when he was born and then he grew, his lifestyle was all prayer. That is why he said men always ought to pray and not to faint. He was most of the time connected with the Father. Hallelujah. He was connected and then he never left the place of prayer. That is why he was able to manifest the power of God on earth. Everything was in the womb of prayer. So the moment he went, he traveled in prayer as Zion needs to be traveled for the city to be rebuilt, for God's manifestation to come to pass. Jesus did it. And then when he birthed miracles, he stepped out and we saw many things happening. People only think about the word, but the word was empowered through prayer. The word that he spoke, was everything was better through prayer. And when it comes out, it comes with power. That's why people saw that his teachings was completely different from the teachings of the Pharisees or the scribes, because he was always in the place of prayer. And he always birthed fresh revelations. Amen. Amen. When you look at Jesus' teachings concerning prayer, when we go to Matthew chapter 6, verse 6, I want us to look at it. It says, "But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet. And when thou hast shut thy door, pray to the Father, which is in secret. And thy Father, which is in secret, shall reward thee openly." I want you to begin to have a picture of what Jesus was trying to say. If you look at the place that he was talking about, it was a confined place that he was talking. A place that there's no disturbances. A place that there will be enough time for God. He said that get to your own closet, shut the door, and then pray to your Father who is in secret. And the Father who is in secret, he said he is going to do what? Reward you openly. That means that you will go to the place of, you will get into the place of birthing. You enter the womb. The womb is a place that is confined. When the seed enters the womb, there's a process that begins. And it is something that is not a one-day process. Hallelujah. When you take the example, a woman who is pregnant, it takes the woman 9 months. That is the natural way. 9 months for the woman to have a breakthrough child, to have the child in her hands. But what happens is that during that period, it's a period of travail. It's a period of struggle. It's a time that when you ask women, they can tell you a whole lot of things. It is not a time of comfort. When they sleep, they have to sleep some stars so that they will be able to feel well. Sometimes they will turn this way. Sometimes they are uncomfortable. You see some people spitting about. It is that around that period, it is not a time that is the same time that the woman is not pregnant. That time that the woman is not pregnant, you see the woman wearing all kinds of heels and then doing all his going about, doing everything normal. But when it comes to the place where she gets pregnant and then the stomach begins to become big, and a whole lot of things takes place in the womb. And that is where the woman wouldn't feel fine until she gives birth. And that is the place that many people don't want to go. When you want to beg a miracle, want to beg the promises of God, you will go through all kinds of stuff. You will face all kinds of opposition. And when you don't, keep on, hold on to, you will miss your miracle. Hallelujah. We thank God for the teachings of faith. Faith helps you to hold on to what you are praying for. But there are some certain issues that you don't pray once and then you go. As some of the teachings of faith says, you have to hit on with prayer. I remember Jesus praying the same prayer, the Bible says three times. He will go and come in some hours and it was the same prayer. He knew what he was doing. That time he was birthing, he was in the place to birth the church in the womb. And he did it. He saw the suffering, the thing that were there. He even told the disciples that the things are not fine with him. He said that in his spirit, it is like what he's going through is leading him to death. And he was not too happy. So he told the disciples, please pray with me. He positioned them in a place. And then the Bible says around in the distance of a stone throw, he went to a place also to pray. But the disciples were very, very tired. They couldn't stay in the womb because the place of the womb was uncomfortable. They were feeling sleepy. But when you are even feeling sleepy in the area of giving birth, you don't sleep. Hallelujah. You will not have that comfort to sleep, as we see. And Jesus, describing the closet makes us see that this is the place that miracles are better. Because he says that when you get there and you close the door and shut yourself and get in contact with the Father, he says that the Father who sees you secretly will bring open manifestation. That means that he will bring to birth what you have gone in to pray for. Hallelujah. Amen. And everything is through the womb of prayer or the vehicle of prayer. Because as you get in there, that is where that promise that is in the womb, as you begin to travel, as you begin to go on with it, with time, sometimes there are some things that will take even years for it to manifest. You don't give up. Because when the woman is going through all that 9 months, she has to endure many, many, many things. The food that she even wants to eat, she can't even eat it. The food that she enjoyed before. Sometimes it's some kind of food that they say, some simple food that they want this one. Sometimes like they want to eat is that when the food comes, they can't even eat it. Life becomes differently. But when we understand how it is, Jesus understood it. That is why he was always in the place of prayer. Sometimes he has to sleep, but he will not sleep. That's why he said that the Son of Man does not even have a place to lay his own head. These days, many people are seeking for skyscrapers. It is not bad to have them, but these ones who are seeking them are not ready to go to the place of prayer, which is the womb of great manifestations. Hallelujah. Amen. So when we learn to get this place, Jesus said it, we will see great things manifest. That's why the psalmist says that he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Thank God, though it's a secret place, these days, science and technology has made us to see many of the things that is in the womb. Through scan, sometimes you can know that the baby is a boy or is a girl or whatever it is, how it is going to be through science. But like, if not science, you wouldn't know what is there. All that you know is that day, that the travail, the woman travails, and then they will say push. When the child comes out, they will tell you, you're giving birth to a baby boy or a baby girl. That's what you will see. But these days, because of science, you will know it even before time, and people will prepare the names and everything, start making their shopping for the child and other things. So when God gives us promises, many people believe that the Bible says the promises of God are yea and amen, and they go to sleep. When women are carrying babies, there's the possibility of miscarriage, which many people have not considered. Many people haven't considered it. There are some causes of miscarriages, and physically, I just took some few points about it, which I want to share. It says that infection can cause miscarriage. And some type of food that are not good for the person who is pregnant can also cause miscarriage. Some kind of food and some kind of diet which are not good. So sometimes your medical practitioner will tell you that avoid some certain food and then stick to some certain things which will keep the child in the womb healthy. And also the medical condition of the mother, you see, such as diabetes and thyroid diseases, there's some diseases that can cause miscarriage. They say hormone problems can also cause miscarriage, and immune system responses also are some of the causes of miscarriage. Physical problems in the mother can also bring miscarriage, and also uterine abnormalities, things that are in the womb. These are the medical terms of certain that can cause miscarriage. So, similar thing, when you bring it to the spiritual, there are some certain things that can cause miscarriage when a person begins to hold on to the promise of God, get to the place or into the womb to bring forth the manifestation of what has been conceived. God speaks to you, say that, I'm giving you this. It's a seed, it's a promise that has been given. And this promise needs to manifest through prayer. Hallelujah. Amen. Through the womb for manifestation. And when it happens, you have to stick to prayer, the word of God, faith, hold on to, and also fellowship. These are some of the elements that will help to sustain the promise to bring it to manifestation. But as we are looking at some of the things that causes miscarriage, some things that we are believing God for can be miscarried because of the attacks of the enemy. And sin is one of it. Satan can cause a person to sin against God, and what God has intended to bring to pass will not manifest. When we look at Adam, there was a big vision for Adam to accomplish. But when he sinned against God, it was the opposite. It was not intended for Adam to struggle, to be a servant, but Adam was made to be a boss, to represent God on earth. But because of sin, everything turned around. I can say that it was something like a miscarriage. Hallelujah. Mm. So he did not see what he was supposed to have till God saw that if he doesn't intervene in this situation, things are not going to be well with man. So he had to send a second Adam, he himself coming down, taking flesh, and then coming to restore things in their proper place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, spiritually, lack of continuous prayer, when we pray while we don't pray again, can also cause miscarriage. You will be believing God that, oh, maybe you are expecting. That's why some people say that God has said it and it is settled. They sit down there, and the enemy, when he has heard the prophecy, he will fight you. The Bible says he is the God of this world. One of the things that we have to understand is that he is in charge of this world. But as we being born again believers, we are in a different kingdom on earth. So what happens is that the Bible says that the thoughts and plans that I have for you, they are not evil, but good to bring it to an expected end. Satan's plan for man on earth is to bring him to a bad end. Opposite that. So when you don't stick to God in prayer, Satan's plan is what is going to happen. Because he has programmed everything for those on earth. That is why when a person is not born again, sometimes what is destined for will not manifest. And the person will come and live and die and go struggling. But when you are born again, God's plans and purpose come intact. Everything is put in shape. But there are some certain things that you need to work out for. Hallelujah. You have to put in some effort as you pray. So as you continue to hold on to prayer in the secret place, you will see the manifestation at the right time. Because when pregnancy takes place, it is not a day, as the prophet was saying. Can a nation be born in one day? Everything is what? Gradual process. Even when the children of Israel were going to possess the promised land, the Lord told them that they should kill the enemies gradually. But when they wiped them out instantly, he said that lions and other wild animals will attack them. So some nations and other things are built gradual. They say Rome was not built in one day. Hallelujah, that's the sayings of the world. So some things are gradual. So the seed have to take shape. The seed in the womb need to be nurtured. The pregnant woman, they will ask him to drink good water, do some kind of exercise and other things. And so that's how it is. So with the word of God, with prayer, with faith and other things, it helps what has been released by God to come to pass. You protect it with prayer and the blood of Jesus. And as you keep on in the rightful time, the burden of manifestation of what is inside will come out. We travail. You see, as soon as Zion travailed, he had it. Amen. So when we begin to, when the time of the burden comes, you travail. Sometimes you see that many, many things begin to happen. As you are holding on to the promises of God, a lot of things, the enemy will be bombarding here and there, but you don't give up. Because getting to the time that the child is going to come for, the pains are more than even the 9 months, that the 8.5 months or whatever it is that the woman went through. It is severe pain. It's all struggle. You will see them shouting and then saying all kinds of stuff. But this is the time that they go through. After they have endured that pain and travail, a child comes forth. And from there, there's rejoicing. So when sometimes things become very tough in our way, we see that the breakthrough is just at the corner. We still have to hold on. So discouragement and unbelief can also cause miscarriage. Sometimes the things that we see, which discourages us, like negative confession, can cause your miracle to miscarry. Because the Bible says that those who come to God, they have to believe that he is and is the rewarder of those that diligently seek him. That is faith. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. So we have to come to God in faith. So we hold on unto, not because of the things that we are seeing, we have to get discouraged. We still hold on to whatever God has said. Because the Bible says that let all men be liars and let God alone be true. God is always true. We are the people who are liars. Whatever God has said, he will surely do it. But we also have a part to play. So everything that we are expecting in manifestation, there are a place that we have to go. And the vehicle or the womb that will bring it to manifestation is prayer. When it comes to material blessing, sometimes we have some things to do. We need to sow some seed, material seed. And even this seed has to go to be sown before the manifestation comes. And there are some certain things that we do, like you have vegetables and other things around. You need to put in some effort to do some cooking before you have the food to eat. You cannot sit down there and you are believing and believing the vegetables to go on the fire and then cook themselves and then come to you. So when it comes to the things of God, there are some certain areas we have to take some steps to do. And there are certain things that we get to the place of travail, the womb of prayer, and then begin to believe God, begin to travail and pray to see, to bring to pass whatever we are believing the Lord for. So when we pray, when we engage in prayer in the womb, let us see some of the things that take place as we go to Revelation chapter 8, 3 to 5. He says, and another angel came and stood at the altar, having a golden censer, and there was given unto him much incense, that he should offer it with the prayers of all saints upon the golden altar, which was before the throne. And the smoke of the incense, which came with the prayers of the saints, ascended up before God out of the angel's hand. And the angel took the censer and filled it with the fire of the altar and cast it into the air. And there were voices and thunderings and lightnings and earthquakes. Hallelujah. The Bible says that we should not cease praying, as Paul also said it. Pray without ceasing. And when we engage in prayer, a lot of things happen that we do not see physically. But our prayer is very powerful. The Bible says that as we engage in prayer, the angels of God in heaven mix our prayers with incense. Incense, in another way, is also worship. And then it gets to the throne when the incense is being burned. Incense is like a smoke that rises and it gets to the presence of God. When it gets there, other things take place. He says that the angel will take a censer and fill it with fire from the altar and he will make a release. So when you don't pray, nothing will come to the earth. But when you begin to pray, they will send fire to answer your prayer. That's why the Bible, there's a song that says that the God that answered by fire, let him be my God. When Elijah confronted the worshippers of Baal, what happened? Fire came. In his prayer, the angel sent fire from the altar of the Almighty to burn the sacrifice over there. And that is where all the people bow. When you don't pray, you will not see the fire come. And when the fire is released, he said there are tenderness, there are voices, a lot of things take place. Your miracle is involved, and the judgment of the enemy is also inside. So when you begin to pray, remember that the angels in heaven are working or processing your prayer. So when the answer hasn't come instantly, you don't give up, because it is in the process, in the womb, ready to bring forth manifestations. Amen. So our prayer is very, very, very powerful. If we remember the promise of Elijah, when these people were, they went into apostasy, serving the Baal worshippers, and then Elijah went to speak and say that, by my word, for 3.5 years there's not going to be rain, nor dew. And it came to pass as he spoke. And Elijah became a wanted man, a wanted prophet in town. They have to send people to search for him all over. But the Spirit of God hit Elijah that they couldn't find him. At the appointed time, because he has spoken, the Bible also says that he will confirm the words of his servant. So God confirmed it, and there was famine everywhere. No food, no water, no nothing. Animals were dying, finishing. And that 3.5 years came to pass. So he showed up to Ahab and said that he should go eat and drink. For the Lord said that there's going to be the abundance of rain. It was something ridiculous before the ears of Ahab. But Ahab later believed. But when Elijah spoke that word, Because God sent him to speak that word that he's bringing rain. This is the promise of God. That some people will say that God has said it, let him do it. So they go and sleep. They go for holidays and enjoy themselves. That was not the issue. The Bible says in James, that the summary of the whole story was in James. He says that the prayer of the righteous availeth man, even as Elijah, who is just like us, prayed for 3.5 years that there was no rain, and prayed again, and there was rain. So when we go to Kings, 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 41, we can see where Elijah engaged in the womb or the place of prayer, which is the womb for manifestation for God to bring to pass what he has said. So we also have a part to play for the promise of God to manifest. So in 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 41, let me read it. It says, and Elijah said to Ahab, get thee up, eat and drink, for there is a sound of abundance of rain. So Ahab went up to eat and drink, and Elijah went up to the top of Carmel mountain, and he cast himself down upon the earth, and put his face between his knees, and said to his servant, go up now, look towards the sea. And he went up and looked and said, there is nothing. And he said, go again 7 times. And it came to pass at the 7th time that he said, behold, there ariseth a little cloud out of the sea, like a man's hand. And he said, go up, say to Ahab, prepare thy chariot, and get thee down, that the rain stop thee not. Hallelujah. So we see here a prophet ordained by God, hears from God, speaks what God says. God has said it. He did not say that because God has said it, let him do it. He said that God has said it. He informed Ahab, go eat and drink. But he himself did not go eat and drink. He has to go to the place of prayer. That is the womb, to make sure the vehicle of prayer will bring the promise of God from eternity to time. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. For great manifestation. The Bible says that he put himself in his knees and started praying, interceding, traveling in prayer. Send the servant, go and see if there's something happening around the seaside. The servant went, there was nothing. The servant, his own, was to see the arrival of the promise. So Elijah was in a place, that is the place of birthing, the womb, traveling in prayer. He was interceding, praying, traveling, praying, and said, go again. He said he went 7 times. And then the 7th one, as he went, he said he sees cloud like a man's hand. That's where he saw that. Getting to the close place that God, Jesus Christ, even said that go, when thou prayest, enter into your closet, shut the door, and as thou have shut the door, pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who is in secret will reward you openly. Elijah's prayer was rewarded openly by that hand of cloud that appeared, and then he sent another information that Ahab, be fast before the rain stop you on the way. And then Ahab started because he believed the words of the prophet. That's why the Bible says that we have to believe God's prophet and we shall prosper. We believe the word of God and we shall be established. Establishment comes, but our prosperity is in the word of the prophet. So when Elijah has made that information, that is where the clouds began to be darkened and black. And the Bible says that the anointing of God came on Elijah that he was able to run. If not that the anointing came on him for him to be run, he would have been stopped by the rain on the way. Sometimes you might prophesy some certain things. When it is happening, when you didn't take care, you also be affected. When he prophesied famine, he was also affected, but God did this thing, supplied him with food, that he was exempted from the famine, but he was in the environment of the famine. That's why it's always good to get close to God, so that he will always sustain and keep us. So we saw the manifestation of what God has said. He promised, but the promise have to manifest through the travail of prayer. So when we get to the place of prayer, the womb, that is the vehicle of prayer, bringing forth things that are in eternity, the counsel, the purposes of God. As we begin to pray, it is like a womb. And as we pray them and travail them, we bring them forth into time. We bring them forth into manifestation. Jesus said that as we pray in secret, he said the Father will bring it forth. Greater manifestation. We have to remember, it is the place of prayer that bring manifestation. So as we allow or get the womb of prayer, we will see great birthing of great promises and great blessings. Whatever God has said or promised to do in our lives, let us not relax. Well, when Satan hears that this is what God is about to do, he will not sit down and fold his hands for you to enjoy that blessing, because he is the God of this world. He says that he is in charge. He told Jesus, it has been given to me, and I give to whomever I will. But we enforce God's blessings and promises through prayer, that his kingdom will come and his rule will be done on earth. Everything is by what? Prayer. And as we engage in prayer, we will see the manifestation of all the things that God has said. So if God has sent us to a place to use us, we have to engage in prayer. And whatever God has said will come to pass. We don't have to be discouraged of whatever we hear, or the things that we see, or what is happening around us. God alone is true. But we will be forced if we don't pray. Paul told Timothy that people had shipwreck because they never believed. They never prayed with the promises through. So through prayer, that is the place, the womb of manifestation. If we get to that place, we will always see the great things that God has said. We will bring forth the things that are in the spiritual realm, the supernatural, the things that are in eternity. We will bring them into time through the vehicle of prayer, through the womb of manifestation. That is prayer. Hallelujah. Yes. May the name of the Lord be blessed. I pray that the Lord will help us, empower us, anoint us with fresh oil of prayer, that we'll be able to engage in prayer. Because prayer is very, very important as long as we are on earth. Because the Bible says that our vessel or our body is a temple, and the temple was made for prayer. That is what Jesus said. So our manifestation on earth is through prayer. So when the temple is idle and empty, the temple is only there for watching only movies or doing other things, polishing, dressing, and other things. Without prayer, we will not see the promise of God. And we might even blame God that, oh, this one is God's fault. Or sometimes we might even blame some of the old ladies who are even innocent, that they are the causes. But sometimes it is we who are not praying. As we get to the place of prayer and travail, we will see every promise that God has made. May the Lord's name be praised and be glorified. Shall we be on our feet as we pray and thank God, asking God to anoint us with fresh oil, to help us to get to the place of prayer, the secret place, the place or the womb of great manifestation, that we will see great things happen, that will make a difference in our society, in our community, in our time, in our generation. Making an impact and difference will always depend in the place of prayer, the secret place. Hallelujah. Shall we stand? Hallelujah.